get started with our concert band, I would like to go ahead and take a moment to recognize our fourth and final honoree for this summer. In 2007, we started an honoree program recognizing folks that have given a lot to Casadero Music Camp. And our fourth honoree for this summer is the director of our guitar program, Ross Thompson. He started with us in 2004 and has done a phenomenal job leading our guitar program. And as a moment of gratitude and thank you, I'd like to present Ross Thompson with a little plaque and thank you.
It's like this timeless thing. I get to know myself a little better, and I certainly get to know this environment really well. It's wonderful for your health. I've discovered simply surviving, you have to get water. There's dirt everywhere. And wind, dryness, all the elements. But really, it's the friendships that I've made long lasting, and the incredible experience of being able to come as an artist and practice uninterrupted. You know, it's rare, and in a place that's so apart from the buildings and noise. So thanks very much for giving me the opportunity to come up here and experience that, you know, and share with you a wonderful children a chance to experience a bit of it too, because you never forget at the age many of them are. You never forget. It becomes ingrained in you when you have a creative experience as a young person that it could be possible. And that's a gift that you carry with you. I know, because I went through it too. Not in a music camp, but similar things from people who know what can happen. In 5 days. 5 days. That's how long it took us to put the telephone together. And it's incredible. Thank you.
I'd also like to take a moment to say thank you to our two health officers this week. That would be Nurse Cheyenne and Nurse Jemin. Director this week is making his debut at Casadero. First time here, and I think he liked it. I know the students really enjoyed working with him. He comes from the University of Pacific. Go Tigers! Please welcome to the stage Dr. Vu Nguyen.
But I just thought the story behind this first piece is so meaningful and apropos to our time together here at camp and our involvement, particularly as educators, in music. So this piece, To Create a Voice, was written to commemorate and celebrate the life of a music educator from Stockton, with whom I had the great privilege of working with, who passed away in 2016. His name was Chris Anderson. He was a trombonist. And so you'll hear in the opening just the solo voice of the trombone building from just one note of concert B flat to B flat to C to B flat CD And then if you listen carefully on the back half of the piece, you'll hear little snippets of, you'll hear a couple little snippets of Hot Cross Buns. But I just wanted to share this quote in here because, again, it just means so much to me. This is from Chris. He says, most people would consider the sound students first make on their instruments to be cringeworthy. But to me, that's music to my ears because that's the first time students put a voice to their instrument. Over time, these voices become stronger. They become clearer, more confident, and get to a point where they use those voices to communicate with each other and to their audiences. And that was just something I spoke with the students a lot about this week, was we're in this business not to play right notes and right rhythms, but to tell a story and to communicate. So we'd like to open the program with Carol Brynn Chambers' piece, To Create a Voice.
Thank you.
This next piece is entitled Saguaro. It's a movement from a larger work called Little Mexican Suite by a Mexican cellist. Her name is Nubia Jaime Don Juan. This piece just came out last year, and so each of the movements, she selected a different type of tree that means something to her. This one, Saguaro, means it's a cactus, if you don't know that. And so this movement is in the style of a danzón. So this is Saguaro. Find a little bit more time for our percussionist back there, and here we go.
Stephen Kyle.
I
stores. Pretty good stores.
Stores?
Yes. Stores.
I figured that piece, that last piece didn't require an introduction. So we will close the program with Sousa's march entitled the Black Horse Troop March, which will turn 100 years old next year. So this is one of my favorite marches. I just also like to take this opportunity again to thank Carolyn and Jonathan Knight, and this has been a great first experience for me on the cast. Very memorable. Thank you to all the counselors and faculty and staff that that worked with our students this week. That's where all of the magic and work actually really happened. So thank you. So thanks again for spending the afternoon with us. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves. We will close with John Philip Sousa's The Black Horse Troop March.
legacy.
Let's give them one more round of applause.
Yeah!
Thank you again for joining us. If you are planning on taking your child out to dinner tonight, you can sign out with their counselors. The counselors are going to, after they pack up their instruments, will be right up in front of our dining hall. And